Hey everyone, it's time for this week's episode of Good Morning Cortland, where we recap the week's top stories. The Marathon Boys basketball team's impressive season ended in a loss on Saturday to the Harrisville Pirates at the State Class D semifinals in Binghamton. The Pirates' defense forced 15 Marathon turnovers, while Harrisville only committed 5 turnovers throughout the game. Junior Diego Castellot led all Marathon scorers with 20 points, and junior Andrew Tillotson scored 17. Following the game, Marathon senior Elijah Teeter received the New York State Public High School Athletic Association's Class D Sportsmanship Award. Diego Castellot was awarded an all-tournament selection from the Class D Basketball Coaches Association. The Truxton Academy Charter School held an open house last week in preparation for what will be the school's first academic year. The charter school received state approval last October after several years of contentious debate. Opponents argue that the school would take money away from the Homer school system, negatively impacting the district. Proponents argue that the charter school would serve to bolster the Truxton community, which has felt a void since the Hartnett Elementary School was closed by the Homer School District in 2015 due to fiscal stress and declining enrollment. The charter school will accept students in kindergarten through second grade and will add an additional grade each year. Organizers estimate that 72 students will enroll in the school this year. The school will accept any student who lives in New York State, with students as far away as Manlius already enrolling. You can learn more about the charter school on our website, CortlandVoice.com. And my guest this week is Jarrett Zeman. He's the assistant director and curator at the 1890 House Museum on Tompkins Street. I had the chance to chat with Jarrett about the museum's upcoming events and to learn more about the building's rich history in Cortland.
We tell the story of Chester Wickwire, who was an innovator in the worldwide wire industry, as well as the story of the Wickwire family and the immigrant servants and factory workers who made him all his money and sustained his lavish lifestyle. We also talk a lot about the Victorian era in this house. Sometimes we think about the past as something that's really very foreign to us and as something that really doesn't relate to any of the ways that we live today. But the Victorian era is actually where a lot of the ways that we live today started. And we talk a lot about that on our tours and reveal those connections for our visitors. On March 29th, 30th, and 31st, where we're going to be doing our Murder at the Mansion event, this is an interactive murder mystery done off of the Clue board game. So we have actors who will be coming in and portraying the suspects, and there's a little drama that you will see. And then visitors will be able to go through the house and solve a series of puzzles that will help them determine the suspect, the weapon, and the room, just like in the Clue board game. And tickets are available on our website, the1890house.org, as well as through our Facebook page. We are open for tours from Thursdays through Saturdays from 11 p.m. to 5 p.m. Our guided tours occur at 1 p.m. and 2:30 p.m. each day, and the house is also open for self-guided tours all day.
Shine on, harvest moon, up in the sky.
Well, that does it for this week's episode. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get notified when a new episode or video gets posted. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram to get updates on what's happening in the Cortland community. And as always, visit our website, CortlandVoice.com, for the latest top stories. We'll see you next week.
So shine on harvest moon for me and my gal.